Inkling's the best character. There have been a lot, and I mean a lot of tier lists out there in the first month of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. And a lot of it is pure speculation, which the top players know is true. Opinions will always be thrown around, so I thought about making a monthly tier list that's based purely off of results, a kind of character pick rate that is based entirely upon a character's game wins within the top 8 of a major tournament. I've organized tiers 1 through 5 based on the amount of points the characters received, with no-show being characters that have not been used in top 8. My name's AustyLaVista, and this is the Smash Ultimate Recap tier list based off of the current meta. In tier 3, we pretty much just have characters that were used by one player that managed to get into the top 8 somewhere. Pac-Man was used by Sinji at New York Excelsior's Pop Up, Falco used by Larry Lur in the bracket reset against Void at Super Splat Brothers, Inkling was used by Exax as well as a bunch of other players throughout various tournaments, Chrom got its report from Tweak and Shoyo James getting 5th and 7th at New York Excelsior's Pop Up respectively. And then we have Link and DK tied at the top because of Salem and Konga's performances at Smash Conference United and Don't Park on the Grass. Tier 2, we start to see some more representation from the characters. Young Link was seen by T getting 3rd at Midwest Mayhem, as well as other players picking him during other top 8s. Pikachu was seen by Esam getting 2nd at Don't Park on the Grass. Fatality, NYXL, and Big D put in some good work for Captain Falcon's spot. Ken winning Midwest Mayhem Ultimate and MKLeo winning Smash Conference United put Sonic and Ike at the very top of Tier 2. At the very top of the list, we have Palutena, who was represented by Nairo, DeBuzz, Jen, and Trevante. A ton of players pull out Olimar for one or two games during Top 8, but what's been putting him into Tier 1 is DeBuzz's performance with the character, getting double the wins in Top 8 as he has with Palutena. Tyroy and Captain L helps with Pichu, but the biggest cause of his placements is Void showing at Super Splat Brothers. Tweak winning every game in Top 8 of Let's Make Moves, the most stacked Ultimate tournament to date, with Wario is what puts this guy in his position as well. Mudace and Big D help for Peach, Sam Sora solidifies it. And finally we got the big two top dogs, Light and Larry Lur's dominant performance cemented Fox near the top of the list, with ZD adding some bonus points. But Snake is the only character to have three fantastic placements by three different players. First for MBD at Don't Park on the Grass, second for Bushi at Midwest Mayhem Ultimate, and third for Ally at Super Splat Brothers. Tier 4 consists of all the characters with three or less game wins in Top 8. Tier 5 were characters that showed up in Top 8 but failed to win a single game, and the rest have yet to make an appearance, with a huge emphasis on yet. I firmly believe we will see tons of variety as the game continues on, and I'm more than excited to see what a super major like Genesis 6 will bring to the table in February. If you enjoy competitive Smash and want to see roundups of all the tournaments, why not check out my Smash Ultimate Recap series, updated every Tuesday. My name is AustyLaVista, and I'll see you all next time.